the time to hash it out.
Yeah. It's hard because this game is so sneaky. It's like, if I hash it out, then does it look suspicious? And, you know, so I'm just like trying to let it be what it is right now and then figure it out. But I don't want to be like, we need to talk, because then what if he gets paranoid? I don't, you know, like I just. Yeah. It's weird. So I don't really know.
No, it's understandable.
Hash it out at like your own time, very discreetly.
And I want it to be genuine. I don't want it to be like, hey, I don't, you know, like, I want it to be real. You know, and the things that we, the fights we had, they were real. It wasn't like a gameplay thing. We had some real things happen. So I want it to be like, if we're going to genuinely have a conversation, I want it to be authentic.
But can you have it on camera, though?
Yeah.
To the level that you're talking about?
Absolutely.
Oh, okay.
One thing with me is I'm an open book. Everybody out. Oh, your hair.
Oh, my hair. I'm sorry.
No, even. To my fans, to everybody, they all know what happened to me in this house. Everything I went through, I'm very open about it. Mm-hmm. So I'm at the point where, like, even Big Brother is like, if you want to talk about it, you can talk about it. So I don't care.
Okay.
But I'm, even that, I'm moving past that part of my life because that was a learning experience. It was super unfortunate. But, like, everything works out for the good. Mm-hmm. I'm great. Like, me and Chris are great. Our life is great. That possibility, you know, didn't come to fruition, but it will down the line. But that's, I mean, I'm not the type of person to hold grudges. So
everybody's so like, I don't know. I feel like
why? Well, you holding grudges, you petty.
I feel like I am.
Who's the mad at from your season?
Well, it's been 10 years, so time heals a lot. But there is a moment where I was just salty over
everything.
A couple people. Who shall remain nameless. But.
No, for real. But that's real. And even with that, this is 2 years removed, and I've had time to process, and I genuinely made up a decision. I was like, I do not want to feel this way. And I was like, I'm not doing that.
That's bondage.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's heavy. I'm not, when I walk into things, or here's the thing, because we're coworkers at the end of the day. If we didn't come back on All Stars, we would be coworkers. We are invited to the same events. We would go to the same parties. I'm not walking in a party and feeling awkward and weird and being mad at people for having it's petty. So I was like, I want to be professional. I want to have a good, you know, work environment. So I made a decision. Thank God, you know, he was receptive. We talked. But I'm not going to be uncomfortable in my skin for anybody, you know?
And then that's a lot of control to give to another person over you.
Over hurt or ego or whatever. And she's like,
I must give up so much control then. Damn.
Eric always says resentment and all that kind of stuff is like drinking poison and expecting the other person to die.
That's good.
Ooh, I like that.
So he always says that to me, and it's true, because that person doesn't know. They're like just living their life, and you're just harboring
it. Half the time, they don't even know you're mad at them.
And it's taking you down. That's all it does.
And you know what I realized a long time ago? This is not real life.
It's not.
Oh, this is no.
It's not.
Fake life.
But those grudges I was holding, girl, listen, you couldn't have told me. I'm like, no, because they, you know, but it's like.
And that's because we're in here 24 hours.